Welcome back to Let's Code. I'm Chris Biscardi, and today I wanted to show you something that's a little bit broken because I feel like on this channel, we often talk about things that are either done or very accomplishable or things that look pretty nice. And I wanted to show that it's not all sunshine and rainbows, and I have to work through things just like everybody else. So I wanted to cover a couple of the challenges that I'm working on with respect to this shield shader that I'm working on. Now, in this particular setup, we've got three cubes. So a cube on the left, a cube in the middle, and a cube on the right, where the right two are the GLTF hexagon sphere from the Bestagon sphere video. So the sphere is a GLTF file that is exported from Blender. We swap out the material in Rust, and then the custom material and the custom vertex shader are doing all of the heavy lifting here. You can see that we still have the pressure wave and we still have the time variable getting sent in. So what's going on here is we've got a fragment shader that is applying the Fresnel effect to the color. And it's also applying the Fresnel effect to the alpha value, which is where I really want it. But as you can see, and as we'll go over in a second, the light doesn't get in from the outside and it doesn't quite escape from the interior either. So you can see that it's working a little bit right now. I've got the alpha blend on, but this is three cubes of the same cube. So they're all supposed to be teal. The middle one has a point light on the right hand side. So the front two faces aren't being lit, which means that they end up being black, because the light from the environment, the ambient light, and any sunlight that we have on the first cube isn't making it to the second cube. So we've got a couple issues. Let's go over what we have set up currently. Again, this setup is very similar to the pressure sphere setup. I can remove this now, I think. So we've got a couple systems here. We've got a setup system. We've got our custom material plugin coming in. We've got the noise from the shader utils plugin that we wrote coming in. We update the time on every custom material in this system. This is the system where we modify the scene. So when the scene gets spawned and we haven't seen it yet, then we apply the custom material and then we never touch it again. And this is animating the light direction for one of the lights. You could see that in the first cube in the example. So again, our setup system has a couple of lights here. We've got an ambient light with an orange red color and kind of a low brightness. We've got a directional light bundle that we rotate, actually. So that's the light that's rotating around in the animate light direction system. And then this is the transform for the next two items. We put a cube inside of the sphere. So in this case, we have the GLB scene zero, which is this hexagon sphere that we exported from Blender. And then we've got this mesh that's a cube that's supposed to be teal. See the color teal here with a standard material on it, not a custom material, in the exact same place. So the sphere should be enveloping the cube in all instances of it. And I've just copied and pasted that three times. So they're all the exact same code. We've got a cube, a unit cube surrounded by a unit sphere roughly. And then we've got our camera. So not too much going on here. You can see that we are not culling any of the faces. So we see the front and the back. This is really important for something that's going to be transparent and kind of shieldy, I think, so that we can see into the sphere, but also we can see behind it, and the things behind it should look a little bit more fuzzy and things like that. We are using the alpha blend mode on our custom material. So this is where we apply that. And then we use a custom fragment shader and a custom vertex shader as well. Our custom material currently takes a time, a color texture, and an alpha mode. We don't use the color or the color texture right now, but we may in the future. And then our mod scene queries for all of our spheres. So we query for the entity, any handles to a mesh, and the name that haven't had the inserted component on them yet. And this is really important because there was a bug in the pressure wave. There was a bug in the pressure wave example, where when you compiled, there was kind of like what felt like a race condition where the material wouldn't update. And that was because this was running for every sphere every time. So we were just constantly reinserting the custom material for a given sphere, which was wonderful, which we solved by inserting this component after we're done. So now the only scenes that we should get are the scenes that don't have the inserted component on them. Thus, they don't keep reinserting themselves. So we take the entity, and in this case, we're spawning a point light bundle on each of the cubes. That's why we get the right-hand side light. So right here, there's a point light inside of this sphere. There's a point light. That's why we can see this show up as blue, because the light doesn't come in from the outside. And then if we look on the right-hand side, that side, I think, of the cube isn't even visible to the camera. So all we see is darkness because no light's getting in. Of course, we do the debug thing where we set up the vertex attribute colors because I like that for debugs or for debugging. And then we take our custom material, we remove the standard material off of the sphere, and we insert our custom material. So not too much different from the pressure sphere or the pressure wave sphere. We can dive into the vertex shader. The vertex shader is exactly the same as the pressure wave sphere. So we apply this sine wave to the sphere, and it kind of bumps along over time, which brings us to the fragment shader. So the fragment shader is interesting. The fragment shader is where I'm having all of my problems right now. So first of all, let's get rid of this input because we don't use it. The noise is coming from a simplex noise algorithm. We use X, Y, and the time for the noise. The alpha is the noise plus 1/2. We could probably just smooth step this as well. That would be fine. I go back and forth on putting this in. We'll see why in a second. The highlight is the highlight of the position diff. So this is a number from 0 to 1. That represents how much of the highlight should be applied. The highlight specifically is the area along the active bump along the pressure wave. I finally got some Fresnel algorithm to work. This happens to be the exact code from the Bevy 0.8 blog post release. So they had a video in there that I guess was supposed to be a tutorial, but it didn't really explain very much. It just kind of showed an example. So I'm going to be honest and say that because they didn't explain what any of this code does, I now don't understand what any of this code does. After reading about Fresnel for a couple days now, this is basically taking the edge of like a sphere or something like that and only applying kind of a gradient in from the outside edges. So if we look at what's going on here with the pink color, it's strongest at the edge and then it fades away as we get inside. And that is what the Fresnel effect is doing for us. Now, I want this to apply to the alpha value because I want to be able to see what's ever inside this shield. So I want to apply basically 1 minus this Fresnel effect. So as the alpha value. So the interior should be invisible and we should gradually get to the exterior. And it kind of works. Like we're kind of getting some blending here. We still have an issue with the light not getting through. So I think that one of the things that I'm going to have to do is take an option here. And if I can finish the depth buffer PR, then in our fragment shader, I think we can reach through this and look at whatever is inside and then render that on the outside. I don't know if that'll work because we're displacing the vertices. I think it will though. So I think that one of the effects that I'm working on here is going to be hung up on the depth buffer PR that I'm working on. And to put that more of a point on that, the depth buffer is going to allow us to take a transparent material like the one that we have now. And basically you can think of it almost as rendering the scene without that. And then we can look at the position here or the position here or the position on this face. And we can say, okay, what's being drawn here? And then we can use that in our calculation for what to draw in the transparent shader material that we're working on. That is not currently implemented in Bevy, as we've discussed before. So hopefully I can get that done and then that will fix itself. I've also had a lot of trouble with the Fresnel and specifically anytime I use normals. So this happens to be just the pink color times the Fresnel, which gives us that black on the interior, pink on the exterior effect. And then I'm applying 1 minus the Fresnel for the alpha value. If I do just 1 here for the alpha value, it breaks in a really horrible way, right? So we've got this like patchwork of I don't even know what to call this. I think this is like maybe a Z order rendering issue or something. I honestly don't know. I don't know what's causing that. Maybe the values are blown out of the scope or something like that, but I honestly don't know. So I get a lot of these effects when I'm working on this particular shader. I get a lot of like, hey, this is like very broken. So yeah, I think the other interesting thing to look at maybe is the alpha mode. So the alpha mode here, if we comment that out, I think what we end up getting is roughly the effect that we actually want. So it's something like this, but I don't want the interior to be black. I want it to be transparent. So for that, we need the transparent material, which means we need to enable this alpha mode. And then of course, if I put Fresnel in as the alpha value, then we can get this kind of effect too, where we have the rendering issues that we were seeing in the other example, or the other iteration of this example. And then we can see the cube that is like almost clearly overlaid too much over the sphere. Like the sphere is rendering behind the cube. And I'm not really sure why that is either. So I've got a couple of challenges here, a couple of things that I need to fix. I think that we're pretty close. I mean, it's not like this isn't working at all. I do think that I need to finish the depth buffer PR, not just for this shader in particular, but also for the intersection effect that I want to include on these shaders as well, where a sphere can intersect with, say, a plane or anything going through the shield. And I just want to be able to show those intersections, or like where like the area around the thing that's intersecting with the shield. So yeah, I just wanted to say not everything is sunshine and rainbows. And sometimes it takes a while to figure out what's working, why it's working, and what to go with. But hopefully we will have this shield up soon. I would really love to, you know, expand on this and build more of them. So hope you enjoyed this. It was a little bit more exploratory, a little bit less of a defined ending, but I will see you in the next video.